Thank you very much. Good morning to you all. And my special wishes in regards to Suresh, Mr. Ravinder Sannareddy garu, P.L. Harnath garu, Pratosh Kumar Garath garu, and of course D. Ramakrishna garu, Chairman CII. To the partners from the industries and also from the investors community, and my colleagues from the state of Andhra Pradesh, I'm pleased to extend this warm welcomes and my warm gratitude to each of you for accepting my invitation to the session on exploring ideas to revive Andhra Pradesh's economy. As we all are aware, COVID-19 outbreak is an unexpected event and has affected the world and has also affected India severely. The pandemic has muted economic activities, disrupted the global supply chains. It has jeopardized livelihoods of millions of people and put to test the resilience of our healthcare and welfare systems. This has also presented a window of opportunity for India to emerge as a favorable global investment destination. A Atmanirbhar or a self-sufficient nation, as spoken out by our Honorable Prime Minister, marking the first year of its governance, the state of Andhra Pradesh also moves ahead with boundless energies and determination to uplift the livelihood of all its citizens through industrialization and job creation. During March and April of this year, the economy of this country and particularly my state had come to a very standstill, and it had severely affected the livelihoods of hundreds of thousands. I would like to bring in a case in point over here to you, sir. The state of Andhra Pradesh, although it is on a thriving industrialization sector, looking for thriving much more growth in that particular sector, a majority of it comes from our agriculture products and from agrarian economy. It is also the marine, or it could also be the non-marine and other fish and food businesses, so such and so on. But these were the very low-carb industries. I mean, the industries at the bottom rung of the industry in the pyramid, which were really affected because of the lack of labor available for these industries. So I think that was one of the times when we have realized that we do also have an in-house labor which is actually not being tapped so far. So that is the reason why today the government of Andhra Pradesh is gone back to this, to its drawing books, and it's looking at the various people or the assets available to us in every village by way of we doing a sort of like a monitoring, we're doing like a mapping app very soon. So to understand exactly where the workforce is sitting and what are they doing and what is we need to get them back onto the factory floor. Also, I would like to bring out the government of AP has taken the whole of government approach to combat the crisis by means of technology for dynamic mapping of hotspots and buffer zones. Issue of e-passes for manufacturing and trust-based approach to know lockdown based on the severity of the cases. Keeping the importance of MSMEs in achieving the vision for sustainable industrialization and their potential contribution to the state economy, we are the first state in the country to revive MSME sectors through a 1,110 crores restart package on April 30th, 2020, and even completed implementation of the same by 30th June 2020. This, along with schemes such as YSR Navodayam and Dr. YSR Nirma, stands testimony to the state's support and commitment to industrialization. All the more during such testing times and going forward, we have released almost close to about 905 crores of pending incentives to the MSME sectors in the two phases. That was in May 2020 and June 2020, both the phases we've completed. We've also waived 188 crores of fixed demand charges towards power for a period of 3 months from April 2020 to June 2020 for MSMEs. We have created a fund of 200 crores to enable micro and small units to meet the liquidity crisis and provide at a very low cost working capitals. Government is also looking at one of the largest consumers of various products, and of these products, the spending of the exchequer is one of the highest. To realize the benefits of scale in procurement government projects, we have launched Dr. YSR Nirman, an innovative program to ensure quality and timely available of cement for all the government projects at the lowest rates. Launched on 8th April 2020, it is integrated with 31 cement companies under one umbrella. Complete transparent procurement system, 100% integrated with CFMS, has been there to make sure that seamless payments is able to be made out. Till date, 26,511 Indians have been placed by the departments and 3.38 lakh metric tons of cement has been placed for delivery. These steps, although important, are only short term. For a long term sustainable growth, India and we, the states, need to comprehend the growth of other South Asian nations. So today, one of the foreigners that we take it up very seriously is, when we are competing, we are not competing with another foreign state over here, but we are going to be competing with the likes of Vietnam, with the likes of South Africa, South Korea, and then also Thailand, Hong Kong, and etc. Aligning these lines, we have considered that we have created a task force, a country-based task force to attract investments from USA, South Korea, Japan, Taiwan, Vietnam on a long-term basis into the state and capitalize on companies' ambitions to diversify supply chains from China. We are committed to developing Andhra Pradesh as a globally preferred investment destination and withholding the number one position in the ease of doing business in India. Throughout the year, we have been engaging with embassies, consultants, industry associates in various organizations and countries to promote and sustain the brand Andhra Pradesh in the field of trade and investments. We have also created an impressive industry cluster ecosystem for electronics in the Nellore Chittoor region. Are in the process of expanding these clusters. Recently, you are also aware that we have also inaugurated a new cluster near Kadapa, almost close to about 3,500 acres. To support the industrial growth, we are also investing in future through fast-tracking development of industrial infrastructure, connectivity and holistic revamp of education and skill landscape in the state. We aspire to continue to be the best state in ease of doing business as we plan to release the new industrial policy as soon as Wednesday. Our assurance to the investors is incumbents free land, quality power and water at competitive prices, skilled workforce and proactive and transparent governance. Before I close out, I would like to say a few points. I would like to bring out what this government's initiatives has been. I think right from the onset, the government and the Honorable Chief Minister has said that we need to strengthen the pillars of the institutions. We need to relook at the complete way the business is being done, or the way the governance of this state has been happening. So that is the reason why we have invested heavily in our education sector. We have invested heavily in our health and our health infrastructures, our systems. We have now also gone ahead and have created, we said, we're going to be creating the world-class workforce. We are going to be constructing 30 skill development colleges spread across Andhra Pradesh, and where we have a tie-ups with the likes of from Singapore, from Germany, and also from United Kingdom to assist us in these programs. Apart from this, we also have the world-class Fortune 500 companies helping us out in their technologies-wise. See, what I would like to point out over here is the opportunities that have come in by way of this COVID are immense. And I think such are administrations who are nimble enough and are proactive enough, I think they will be continuing to take the advantage, early bird advantage. And I certainly think Andhra Pradesh stands at the forefront of creating the greatest interest, greatest opportunities, and also the land of destinations for all the future investments, we believe, in the Southeast Asia.